up? How you guys doing today? Welcome back to the channel. We are listening to some Mahogany Rush. We are going to listen to the track. Hold on, I don't even have it up right here. We're gonna listen to the track "The Answer," which is off of the album Mahogany Rush 4, which was released in 1976. It has been a long time since we last listened to Mahogany Rush. As a matter of fact, it was December 21st. I'm looking at the date right now, 2019. That I had last listened to Mahogany Rush. This was a long time ago. But a few of you in the comments had kind of gathered together. I love when you guys do this. I love when you like work with each other. A few of you in the comments had kind of worked together. And you're trying to get me to listen to one of the songs from them. And eventually you guys came to a consensus to listen to "The Answer." So, by popular vote, we're going to listen to "The Answer" from Mahogany Rush. I hope that you guys enjoy it. Thank you as always for being here. Hope you're having a lovely day. Hope you're doing well. Hope you're feeling good. Hope your day's treating you well. Hope that your night's putting you down well. Hope that lunch, dinner, and breakfast goes well for you. It was good. What'd you have? You don't need to answer that. Let's go ahead and get into the music. I'm talking too much. The Answer. Let's do it. Great playing. Really great playing. Loving the instrumental part of this. Loving that bass. Loving the feel of the guitar. The drumming is fun to play along with. Like, I'm here doing it. But, like, in my mind, I'm like a rock star. Like, I'm really playing along with those drums. The guitar, I love the sustain and the way that the notes echo back and forth in the ending. Like, they're allowed to kind of, I mean, you're probably using the volume, but, like, turning it down and then kind of raising it back up. It just kind of hits in different waves. But I really love the sound of that bass as well. I mean, that comes together really well. The instrumental part of this, I thought was fantastic. I'll admit, I don't really like the vocals. I don't know. It was they didn't sound bad, but at a certain point, I did completely tune out the vocals, and I was just listening to what was going on instrumentally in the back, because I found it a lot more interesting. I found that the musicians were just, like, just going off. And the vocals kind of reminded me a little bit of Frank Zappa, but if I'm being honest, without the comical charm. Like, they're just kind of lacking that. And I, after a while, I was kind of like, I don't want to say annoyed at the way he was singing, but I wasn't enjoying the vocal performance as much as the instrumental part, which, like I said, musicianship-wise, this is top tier. Now, Frank Marino is going to be handling all of that guitar, and then the vocals. And then Paul Harwood on the bass. Harwood is... he's jamming there. That's really good. And then Jimmy Iobe on the drums there. But Frank Marino's guitar? That was singing. This is a track that I would love as an instrumental. It's dynamic. It's impactful. It's energetic. It soars. There's good changes in there. And like I said, because I was listening and focused so much on the instrumental part of it, it just has this, I think, unique energy to it. It reminds me in some ways, if you were to, like, mash together Rush Kansas and Frank Zappa. But at the same time, it feels unique unto itself. There's a deep-rooted funk in that bass, especially. Let me back it up just a bit. Get to the beginning here. You hear that bass? Oh, yeah. There's a great sense of melodic drama as well in that guitar. This is good. Yeah, the way they build it up, break it back down. Yeah, right there. Love that little bounce that they get into on the drums. Da 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 taps. That feels really good. I like that. Let's do these lyrics, huh? Hey, yeah, I'm standing inside a silver room, a sound inside my head like a sonic boom. Well, the preacher, just you don your purple and black, is tearing sacred pictures in my naked back. Said, hey, preacher, and he smiles in return. I think you want to see me burn? Yeah, you're squeezing off my blood. Please tell me why. But he proceeded to break down and cry. I got no idea what's going on in here. Is he in confession? I'm standing inside a silver room, a sound inside my head like sonic boom. Preacher. Maybe the preacher is like trying to spiritually align him. But the preacher is the one that's needing spiritual alignment? Ah, does someone know the answer? Tell me, Lord, does someone know the answer? I'm floating beyond the cosmic dream. A feeling in my throat makes me want to scream. Well, all lover who has no love to spare is ripping out the roots of my love and hair. Said, hey, lover, and she made a drunken face. Well, put yourself in my place. Please tell me why you want to see me hurt at all. But she proceeded to break down and bawl. Does someone know the answer? I don't know what the question is. I don't know what the answer is, because I don't even know the question. Well, I'm old, I'm tired and low, I'm feeling like a rainy day. I've been searching for a being who's seen what I've seen. And I know I'll find him someday. He's searching for this person. He's searching for an answer. I just don't know what the question is. I don't know. I enjoyed the musical aspect of this. Let me know what you guys thought. In the comments below. Thank you for being here. Hope that you have a lovely day. A beautiful one out there. I'll see you later. Bye.